Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Battle for Azeroth as we're heading over here to do the next scenario and meet our team members who are going to be helping us as we travel through Stormwind City, of course as uninvited guests. So here are our new team members, and here's Nathanos Blightcaller. Of course he has some important information for us, and of course we're going to be doing the Stormwind extraction scenario, which is actually pretty long and pretty interesting, actually. So he gives us this potion, Blightcaller's Easy Death, of course. Once you take that potion, you'll go to sleep and you won't ever wake up. So that's pretty crazy. You don't want to mess with that too much because that's not very fun now, is it? So this is going to be our form of transportation. We have these beautiful, majestic Skyhorn Eagles to take us to Stormwind City, so it's going to be a nice, smooth ride to Stormwind City.
Listen closely. We will not be in contact once we have entered Stormwind. You, Thalissera, and Rokan will infiltrate the stockades and extract the prisoners. Our scouts have located a hidden entrance. The Tauren and I will cover your escape. The War Chief and the Horde will disavow all knowledge of this mission should you be captured. I have supplied each of you with an easy death. If you find yourself out of options, use it.
Alright, so we finally arrived out here in Stormwind City with this beautiful, majestic music in the background. But of course, we're here to infiltrate Stormwind City, starting this by breaking the padlocks so we can enter the secret entrance into the Stockade's dungeon. So here we go. As we jump in, of course, we have our two team members to back us up here. It is time to get down into the action, right? Now, of course, this combat's going to be slightly different than the first scenario in my previous video, because there it was adjusted for, you know, 10-man player mode. So all the health pools were adjusted. They're much stronger and difficult to deal with. But in this one, it's just you, and of course you have some backup. But you can still notice that there is still kind of a slight, you know, your character kind of feels a little underpowered. And that might just be the gear and stuff like that. Or in the previous video, I also said it could be because we're missing the artifact weapon ability, which I kind of agree with that, because at times it does feel like you're missing an ability, you know, because that helped you and it provided you with the extra damage buff. You know, it made the combat a little more easier and smoother for our sides, of course. But you know, it's just something you have to get used to for this new expansion. Maybe there's stuff that's missing out. Who knows? So here is High Overlord Sourfang in this prison cell. And I was actually quite surprised when we talked to him. So he lost track of time here, and after all that she's done, he will not return to the Horde. And make sure you know the difference between loyalty and honor. So I'm guessing what we did back then with all the chemical warfare against the Alliance, he wasn't a big fan of that. He was pushed too much by Sylvanas, and he has now backed out of the Horde, which is kind of sad. You know, he kind of lost his position. Maybe he's trying to find a new purpose in life or something. I don't know. He's on a different road now. But maybe they're just kind of pushing him off to the side, so later on, when we get deep in some trouble, maybe he will come to the rescue, of course. Always a good way to surprise people, right? Maybe there's some good writing behind all this. Who knows? We just have to wait and see once we get further into this expansion. To this point, I'm just kind of popping the cooldown, just seeing how much it helps out with the combat. And of course, we're headed over to the next destination to meet our next two team members. As you see, two trolls here from the Zandalari tribe. We have a prophet and we have the princess. Two very important people, part of a very important group of people who can help the Horde as we journey into the new continents for Battle for Azeroth. So at this point, we've been silenced by some mage commander, of course, rendering us useless for the most part as we can't use the most of our abilities. One thing that is weird, right? You see that we're all silenced here, but right here, you will see when we're getting out of this arcane barrier prison, all of a sudden she was able to use some kind of spell or something to break the barrier. I was confused because, like, I thought we're all silenced. How does she all of a sudden was able to do this to set us free? And of course, we get our revenge in the Mage Commander as we all fight her and take her down so we can get out of the stockades and escape Stormwind City as quickly as possible. So of course, we find the exit from the stockades. We find our way to Stormwind City. And of course, things are not going to be easy. So we're here as a group, a nice team group. We're going to escape here by using the stealth of the Loa provided by our friend here. We have to try to stealth our way through Stormwind.
Citizens of Stormwind, Horde infiltrators have breached the stockades. Civilians are to remain in their homes until the threat has been subdued by order of the king.
So, you know, that always makes things harder. Now the whole town is on lockdown. You know, they're alert. They know that we are here.
Jump off the bridge.
And this scene is pretty funny. He's like, jump off the bridge. I was like, oh my God. So I was the first one off the bridge. I hit the water first. And I didn't show it too much, but up on the bridge, it was Anduin, the king of Stormwind, and his crew. So of course, we had to jump off as they had, you know, greater detection of stealth. So we would have been caught and most likely been killed by the Legion of the Alliance. At this part, she has an arcane barrier trying to keep us safe as you see these crazy, rabid, mysterious, and ferocious worgens attacking us. Now imagine being in this situation for real life. I mean, that'd be pretty terrifying as you see these werewolves trying to rip you apart, take your life away. But of course, I will not let that happen to me or any of my friends here. And here's Lady Jaina Proudmoore. She is still angry of what happened to her and her people caused by the Horde. So she's trying to stop us here. And for some reason, I don't know why, but I attacked her just to see what happened. And she froze me. And then she started casting the ability called Shatter, which will kill me instantly, as you see there. So she runs back off. I reincarnate. She aggroes right back to me. She freezes me again. And you already know she's going to shatter me to death again. So at this point, we have the Skyhorn. He brought his eagles to bombard the Alliance, kind of take the attention away and allow us to get to the end of the dock, where we are once again met by Lady Jaina Proudmoore. And things get a little weird here. I thought it was going to be another bloodbath, but something strange happens with Prophet Zhu here. He talks to Lady Jaina Proudmoore and gives her a complete change of heart that allows us to escape. So I'm curious as to what exactly he told her, because it must have been something pretty intense for her to completely change her mind after trying to kill us this whole time. So at this point, we're going to be taking the ship, following the princess, and go to Zul'Dazar. And here we are finally at the port of the Zandalar with Nathanos Blightcaller. We're going to be completing this quest, of course. The nice, easy experience with no bugs. And here we are on this beautiful island, a new place for the new expansion. I'm so excited and can't wait for what is to come. Here's a picture of the map. It's kind of in the middle of Azeroth here. Very nice location. But anyways, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, sub to my channel, and I'll see you next time.